All right. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the 2015 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from Tucson, Arizona. My name is Sexy Beast, and I'm here with
Professor Lou Bottomy.
And this is the first time we're working together. I'm so pleased.
This is going to be a great game. I'm incredibly excited about this. We've seen a couple great games already today, and this one going for the number 5 seed.
That's right. Game number 15, number 5 seed. That's going to be between the Terminal City Roller Girls and the Mad Rollin' Dolls. That's Terminal City All-Stars and the Dairyland Dolls. A very exciting matchup. These two teams both having won 2 games already in this tournament this week, having dropped 1. But here they are competing for the coveted 5th spot in the tournament. So it should be very exciting.
All right, we're going to go ahead and let you know who's going to be going out there for the Mad Rollin' Dolls today. Starting out, we've got skater B1T, that's Fandangled. We got skater number 4 is Mouse. D4 is Magic Missile. L5, Brokeback Jack. The captain, 9mm, is Shenanigans. Number 10, Sproutin' a Tail. Number 14, Darling Nikki. Number 15, Mac the Knife. 155 is Lip Smacker. 18 feet is Alligator. Number 31, Lady Hoo Ha. Number 80, Thrill Show. 255 is Tipsy Velvet. And 565 is Glotness.
All right, and skating for the Terminal City All-Stars in red, wearing the Maple Leaf pants. It's number 101, Red Sonia. 1111, Sundown. 1223, Kim Janna. 131, Bruiseberry Pie. 16, Palmer. 19, Anna War. Number 305, Susie Smoke Show, otherwise skating as Wilson. Number 31, Eve Hallows. Number 51N, Simonius Smaximus. Number 52, Aveda Peron. Number 69, Flower Plower. Number 88, Maiden Sane. Number 90, Green Machine. And number MG42 Griffith, the Terminal City All-Stars, coached by Mac the Mouth and Jude Newman.
Now, both these teams, as you said, they went 2-1 getting here. Let's take a quick little shot on how they got here. Terminal City won their first game against Tri-City, 328-90. They lost their second game against a hard-hitting Bay Area Roller Derby, 77-251, and came back to win the third game against Team United, 196-171. Mad Rollin' Dolls got here by way of beating AZRD on the first day, 221-171. Then they saw the juggernaut buzzsaw that was VRDL. 33-404 was that game. Came back to win a great game against Charm City, 239-152. And that brings us where we are now.
That's right. We are just about 5 seconds from getting underway on the Fast Girl Skates. Jammerline for the Mad Rollin' Dolls. That's number 4, Mouse. And she will be squaring off against number 88, Maiden Sane. And that whistle starts the jam. Maiden Sane trying to make her way through the pack there. Terminal successfully blocking out the Madison Jammer. It looks like she is headed to the penalty box for a track cut. And that's the first penalty of this game.
Mouse starting it off early.
Penalties being very important in all of these games so far. Maiden Sane coming around through the pack, picking up 5 points for Terminal City. That's the first points of this game. Penalty trouble for both of these teams was evident in their earlier games. I'm able to overcome it, but certainly you want to keep your jammer out on the track. And out on the track right now, of course, Maiden Sane in her second scoring pass, picking up 5 more points for Terminal City All-Stars.
Yeah, Mad Rollin' Dolls picking up another penalty there. So still having a little bit of problem with that as Terminal City is going to burn around the outside there. Maiden Sane making another 5-point pass.
And that's number 4, Mouse, out of the Derby Supply penalty box. Back on the track here, trying to get through and complete her initial pass. Meanwhile, as you mentioned, Maiden Sane picking up 4 more points for Terminal City. And Mouse is now out of the pack. Pack setting up there in turn 3.
No pack being called. Mouse comes into the inside.
Wow.
3 points given.
There you go. So not a complete waste of time for Madison, but Terminal City picking up 22 points on that jam. 3 for the Mad Rollin' Dolls. Just a minute and a half into our game here.
It's a big way to capitalize on that first power jam, putting up a 19-point spread very early. Terminal City, of course, in the red tops with, it looks like, flowered pants on today. Oh, no,
those are the Maple Leafs. Yeah, the Maple Leaf jammies, yep.
Gotcha.
All right. On the Fast Girl Skates line, number 19, that's Anna Ward jamming for Terminal City. And she's going to be opposed by D4. SD4 Magic Missile jamming for the Mad Rollin' Dolls.
And Missile almost gets out to the front, gets a nice little hip pop there. That was Eve Hallows on that shot.
Oh my goodness, that's Magic Missile heading for the Derby Supply penalty box on a forearm. So that is two jams and two jammer penalties for Madison. And Terminal is definitely going to be able to take advantage of that. Anna Moore completed her first initial pass, and she's coming around on her first scoring pass. Uh-oh.
Another whistle blowing.
Anna Moore picking up a back block, I think, on that play. And she, too, will be headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. We'll have a bit of a jammer swap in the box there.
So tough start so far for Mad Rollin' Dolls. They came into this the number 9 seed for the tournament and the number 35 seed in the WFTDA. Terminal City, the number 27 seed in the WFTDA, and the number 7 seed here.
Yep, and both of these teams will be able to exit this tournament with a higher seed, which I'm sure they are both very pleased with. So Magic Missile has completed her initial pass here. She is going to come around and try to earn herself some points. Terminal City, number 69. That's Flower Plower setting up at the front of the pack there with just two blockers there at the front of the pack. They're unable to stop Magic Missile, and she bursts through, earning herself 5 more points. Meanwhile, that's number 19, Anna War for Terminal City All-Stars. She has come out of the box, gotten through the pack, and harvested 4 more points for Terminal City.
We got about 15 seconds left to go on this jam. Magic Missile slowly coming up on the pack. Finds some nice offensive blocking there.
Yep. Scootered on the inside, a little bit of an apex hop. And just like that, she's assessed 5 more points.
Well, Terminal City was not able to put as many points on that last power jam as they did the first one, and that's a big part to the Mad Rollin' Dolls defense there. So nice job by them killing off quite a bit of that power jam and keeping the bleeding to a minimum.
Yeah, 14 points for Madison on that jam, 6 points for Terminal, bringing our score to 28 for Terminal City, 17 for the Mad Rollin' Dolls. Just about 5 minutes gone here in this contest.
I love this matchup we're seeing out here. And now we've got Iveta Perrone taking on Mac the Knife.
Yeah, Madison set up there on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, doing a great job recycling Iveta to the back.
Well, Iveta's one of those choppy skaters. You just see her legs always chomping, chomping, chomping away.
Oh, my goodness. This is some early penalty trouble here for Madison. Mac the Knife headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. Iveta Perrone still on the track, ready to start her first scoring pass.
And the Mad Rollin' Dolls 3 for 3 on the jams. 3 jams, 3 power jams given up.
Yeah, that's just not going to work out for them. That's number 16, Palmer, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. Meanwhile, Iveta Perrone is back in the pack and ready to score.
Yeah, she's definitely one of those dangerous players out there on a power jam. She's got those great moves to open up those lines.
All 4 blockers on the track for Madison. Aveda's there working through her way through the front.
Yeah, Griffith tried to open up a little hole for her. She saw it was not budging at all, so she tried to find her own line. Does so around the outside.
Mac the Knife is out of the Derby Supply penalty box and back on the track, looking to complete her initial pass, but before she gets a chance to do so, Iveta Perrone is going to call that jam. And that is 15 points on the jam for Terminal City All-Stars, 0 points for Madison.
Well, right now we see that the problem is fairly obvious. Mad Rollin' Dolls with big penalty problems. 3 power jams given away in the first 3 jams. Yeah. Definitely not a way you want to start off in this divisional playoff game.
Nope. All right, on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that is number 10, Sprouting a Tail for the Dairyland Dolls, and number 101, Red Sonja for the Terminal City All-Stars.
Sprouting a Tail doing a little pirouette, trying to find a little bit of a hole to get her shoulder in there.
Yeah, great work inside that pack there from number 69, Flower Power, and number 131, Bruiseberry Pie.
Red Sonja chomping up to the front.
Oh. She made her way all the way to the outside line, but managed to stay in bounds, and she does pick up lead jammer status for the team in red, the Terminal City All-Stars.
Yeah, Brokeback Jack gave her a nice little pop as she was going by, but very adeptly stayed in bounds.
Ooh. Yep, looks like Bruiseberry Pie picked up a penalty there. She is headed to the Derby Supply penalty box, but it seems to have worked out for us. Oh, no. No, my goodness. What is happening here with Madison? sprouting a tail, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. You are right, Lou. That is 4 for 4. 4 jams, 4 jammer penalties, and that ain't good. Meanwhile, Red Sonja has been recycled to the back of the pack here in turn three. Looks like a 4-3, 4-2 pack advantage for Madison right now. And they are going to try to take Sonja all the way back there, and they do. That's number 31, Eve Hallows, coming up to try to free up some space for her jammer. Great job there by 9mm Shenanigans, managed to put out 101 Red Sonja. And that jam ends.
You know, you got to wonder right now, like, if I was the coach on Madison, I would almost think right now is not a bad time to call a timeout.
Absolutely.
Get my girls' heads back together. Yep. They're trying hard, but they're just making small mental errors, yep. And you can't give up these power jams one after the other after the other.
No. On the fast girl skate line right now, that's 12-23 Kim Janna. She's jamming unopposed. Sprout Natale standing in the Derby Supply penalty box. There she is, out on the track again. So
Janna gets driven down to the floor.
So both teams at full strength here. Sprout Natale trying to make her way past number 1111 Sundown.
Got a multiplayer block being called.
Just as soon as I say both packs at full strength, there's two Madison blockers headed to the penalty box. And Kim Janna is out of the pack, having picked up lead jammer status. She's out there and ready to score. And she does. There she is, scooting through the pack, having been awarded 5 points. Sorry, correction, 4 points there for the Terminal City All-Stars.
Yeah, she saw that seam in Mad City. Tried to shut it down, but a nice little burst of speed by Kim Janna got her through. Sprouting a tail, trying to still work her way through the back of the Terminal City defenders.
Yeah, that's number 155, Lip Smacker, for the Mad Rolandals, trying to contain the Terminal City jammer, but she's unable to do so. Janna's back through the pack, picking up 5 more points. Looks like we have a star pass from Madison.
And that is going to Darling Nikki. And this jam ends, but most importantly right now, that was the 5th jam and the first one that Mad Rolandals did not give up a power jam.
Yes, so their jammer did start in the box, but she did come out to the track and managed to not make her way back there. So just like you said, Lou, looks like we do have a timeout here for Madison. They are going to take a minute here and try and collect their thoughts and come up with a plan to stem the tide of these penalties.
Yeah, I will give a little shout out here. Make sure you don't miss a minute of this action by purchasing your WFTDA TV Watch Pass. It's only $15 per tournament, or purchase the D1 and Championship bundle for only $60. Live it or stream it live on WFTDA TV. And that's a great savings of $22.
Yep.
I mean, $60 for 5 weekends of entertainment. And if you are the Derby enthusiast like we are, I mean, that's 10, 12 hours a day. That is like one of the best values if you can't get there.
That is money well spent. All right, back to the fast girl skate line. That is number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha, jamming for the Mad Rolandals, and she'll be opposed by number 88, Maiden Sane.
Maiden Sane putting up 22 points already.
Yeah, Maiden Sane, the high scorer in each of the games that she's skated in thus far. And she is working her way through the back, gets recycled to the outside there. Comes back around. Good put out there by number 9mm Shenanigans.
Well, Terminal City defense doing a beautiful job holding Lady Hoo-Ha back, driving her out of bounds and recycling her.
Yep. Oh my goodness.
Some big hits there.
Tough block there by number 18FT Alligator.
Maiden Sane is through the pack. She does not pick up the lead jammer status there.
Yep. Lady Hoo-Ha there. I don't know if she was able to pick up any points. No, I don't think she was, but she did get lead jammer status, and she did call off the jam there on a defensive move. So,
hey, that's another jam.
Yeah, that's another jam without a jammer penalty, and that's good. So right now we're at 64 points for Terminal City All-Stars, 17 for the Mad Rolandals. 20 minutes left here in the first half. Back to the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. That is number 4, Mouse, and she will be opposed by number 19, Anna War.
64-17, the present score, 19 minutes, 50 seconds left to go in this game, or first half.
Anna War working her way to the inside, meeting some resistance there from number L5, Brokeback Jack. Somebody has been sent off on a penalty there. There's a chorus of whistles coming from the cluster of referees. Looks like that is a Madison blocker, the pivot, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. That is number 14, Darling Nikki.
and just had to make sure as she was going by that she wasn't holding a jammer penny in her hand.
Oh, man. That would be just bad news for Madison.
Oh, Mouse.
Extensive blocking there at the front of the pack by Griffith, but that's not enough to keep Mouse from breaking through and picking up lead jammer status for the team in white.
Yeah, I love how Mouse can just take a nice beating, and then you see her coming back around with a little grin on her face.
Gets tough blocking on the inside.
To the inside.
Yeah, that's a...
That one knocked the grin off her face.
That's number 305, Wilson.
Terminal doing a great job with a three wall on the back. Been able to hold the jammer from the get-go. Mouse is going to get up, calling it off.
Yep, looks like we got MG42 Griffith for Terminal City headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. The result of, like you said, some heavy work there on the inside. So,
this next jam is going to be brought to you by Rydell Skates. Handcrafting quality roller skates for 70 years. Rydell Skates.
Right on. 70 years, that is a long time. Thank you, Rydell Skates. All right, on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line for Terminal City, that's number 5-2, Aveda Perrone. And she'll be opposed by number D4, Magic Missile, for the Dairyland Dolls.
Magic Missile, the lead scorer right now for the Dairyland Dolls with 14.
And there goes Aveda Perrone. She's worked her way around the outside, picking up lead jammer status for Terminal City. Followed closely by D4, that's Magic Missile. Aveda's going to try to get through, pick up some points here. Oh, no.
And it looks like...
That's not too good. That's Terminal City's picking up a jammer penalty of their own. Aveda Perrone headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. And she's going to be followed by number 90, Green Machine, for Terminal City. Meanwhile, back in the pack, Magic Missile has completed her first scoring pass. Picked up 5 very needed points for Madison. Nice three wall there at the front of the pack from Terminal City. Magic Missile working her way around, getting cycled to the inside there by Griffith.
Well, Mad Dolls, their defense came up trying to give her a little help there. And Terminal City just weaved their way through them and went right back at Magic Missile.
Yeah, that's number 31, Eve Howells and Griffith working their magic at the back of the pack, trying to stop the magic from happening. But you can't hold back the magic. Magic Missile through the pack, picking up 5 more points for the Dairyland Dolls.
Veda Perrone back in from the Derby Supply penalty box.
And also Green Machine back from the box, helping her colleagues there at the back of the pack. Magic Missile having been recycled a number of times. Here comes Aveda Perrone. She's found her way to the back of the pack. Sprinting to the inside, headed right up the middle there, picking up 4 points, I would think. Yep, 4 points for Terminal City. 10 points for Madison so far on this jam, 8 for Terminal City. Pretty evenly matched thus far.
Oh! Green Machine and Griffith have been having Magic Missile's number right now.
Yeah, they just... Absolutely shutting down the offense for Madison here.
Aveda Perrone, again, those chompy legs.
Yep.
And just always going.
Chomping through, earning 5 more points for Terminal City. So that jam comes to a close. And with an even score, 13-13. 13-13, that's almost a palindrome.
A palindrome?
Yeah.
And it's not even brought to you by Radar. But this one is palindrome break. Cigar, toss it in a can, it is so tragic. That palindrome brought to you by Radar Wheels.
I'm not sure what that means, but it is a palindrome. So, meanwhile, back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that's number 15, Mac the Knife, being opposed by number 101, Red Sonja, for the Terminal City All-Stars. Red Sonja in red with the magic maple leaf pants. And they're magic enough to get her through the pack, allowing her to earn lead jammer status for Terminal City.
Terminal City turning it on now, 77-33, the score before this pass here.
And Mac the Knife has found her way through, too. She's coming up on her first scoring pass. Red Sonja goes through, picks up a few points there, and decides she wants to shut down the scoring for Madison. Looks like the Terminal City coach is calling for a timeout. 4 points for Terminal on that jam, 0 points for Madison. Our score with that timeout at just over 15 minutes left in this half. Terminal City 81, Mad Roland Dolls 33.
And we'll give us time to give you some more shout-outs. You're making its 10th year of pushing the sport's athleticism and competition to new heights. The International WFTDA Playoffs and Championships bring together the most talented skaters and teams in the WFTDA. Join us next week for the 2015 International WFTDA D1 Playoffs hosted by the Dallas Derby Devils. Live it or stream it live at WFTDA.com/Dallas.
That's going to be an exciting tournament, as are all of the rest of the D1 tournaments, Lou.
Hey, and you know what? This palindrome is not sponsored by Radar Wheels. There is another palindrome, Taco Cat.
Taco Cat.
And amazingly, Taco Cat is a taco delivery service in Minneapolis.
It is.
It's a whole nother reason to go all the way up there for championships. Tacos delivered to your door.
That's right. And if you aren't planning on going to championships, but you do live in the Minneapolis-St. Paul area, please get a hold of Taco Cat. Oh, well, meanwhile, back at the Fast Girl Skate Line, that is number 1223, Kim Janna, and she is being opposed by number 10, Sprouting a Tail.
And Matt Rolandahl is doing a good job after those first four jams, not picking up any more or giving away any more power jams. I'm waiting the announcer's curse on that right now.
Yeah, so far for Terminal City, it looks like it's just they made a Perrone with one penalty. And the other jammers are not. Uh-oh, looks like we picked up a cutting the track call here for Madison. Those jammer penalties problems persist. And that's number 10, Sprouting a Tail, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box.
The curse of announcer, it is a real thing.
It's been proved time and time again this weekend. So, meanwhile, back in the pack, Kim Janna encountering some trouble there on the outside, getting blocked to the outside there by, what is her number there, 565 Glock Ness. Kim Janna having to go all the way around to the back of the pack.
About another 50 seconds left to go in this jam.
Yeah, that's number 14, Darling Nikki, at the front of the pack, trying to slow down Kim Janna. Oh, yeah, look at that. Kim Janna picking up an out-of-play penalty for Terminal City. Headed to the penalty box just as Sprouting a Tail had left, so she will sit for the full 30 seconds there. Sprouting a Tail having made her way through the pack and is out front on her first scoring pass. Looking to come out here and try and salvage some points here for Madison. All right, that's number 31. Eve Hallows at the front of the pack. Looks like a three-wall there for Terminal City, doing their best to contain Sprouting a Tail.
Yeah, their three-walls have been very, very effective so far against Mad Rolandahl, as they've been able to have that little floater, whether she's going to help the jammer or do a little defensive work. But there's just some beautiful three-wall work.
Oh, no, look out. Just like that, Kim Janna is out of the box. Yeah, it looks like at the end of the jam there, she tried to do an apex jump. And she was blocked from inside by Darling Nikki, and that has earned her a blocking out of bounds penalty, and she will be headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. And that will leave just three blockers on the track for Madison. Correction, two blockers. Looks like they have two blockers in the penalty box. So it is a three on two pack advantage for Terminal at the start of this jam.
This next jam being brought to you by Adam Skates. Train hard, play smart, skate Adam.
And skating for Terminal City right now, it's number 88, Maiden Sane. And she has picked up lead jammer status for the team in red. And jamming for Madison. Having made her way through the pack, completed her initial pass. That is number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha.
We'll see it a couple more players going to the Derby Supply penalty box there.
Maiden Sane looking to her coach for some guidance. Coach saying, go ahead and call it off. So she does. Having picked up four more points for Terminal City. Right now our score, Terminal City 85, Madison 36. 12 minutes remaining here in the first half.
This next jam being brought to you by Derby Supply. All your derby needs, derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
Just hit it.
And right now it looks like we need a few more players out on the floor. A very, very light starting group out there.
That's right, two blockers for Madison standing in the box. Jamming for Terminal City, that's number 19, Anna War. And she has picked up lead jammer status. And once again, I am sorry to say this, Lou, but it appears that the Madison jammer has picked up a cutting the track penalty. Oh, no, she's back on the track. Okay. All right, very good. God, I didn't want to say that. Thank God I didn't have to. Looks like that may be number 69, Flower Plower, who has been sent to the Derby Supply penalty box. Maybe she did the cut.
Well, you know, it's pretty amazing on Terminal City's defense. They had a two-wall there. And if you guys have been around Derby any amount of time, you know Mouse is a very, very dangerous jammer. And usually on a two-wall, she's going to find her way through pretty effectively. And, and Terminal City just doing a beautiful job on defense so far.
All right, back to the Fast Girl Skates jam line. That's D4 Magic Missile for Madison. And she'll be opposed by number 52, Aveda Perrone. Jamming for the team in red, that's Terminal City All-Stars.
Aveda Perrone picking up 28 points on the day so far.
Great job by Madison there obstructing Aveda. She's at the back of the pack, but oh, wow, getting cycled to the outside just as two Madison blockers are leaving the track. It's number 565 Glock Ness and number 255 Tipsy Velvet headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. Aveda Perrone has made her way through the pack. She's out front. She's your lead jammer. And she is jamming against a pack of two, which doesn't make things too difficult for her. She's hopped through and then picked up her points and called off the jam.
Yeah, very, very light pack out there.
Yeah. Madison really definitely experiencing some significant penalty trouble here in the first 20 minutes of this half.
They've already got one skater. Shenanigans already has four penalties.
Yikes.
And we've still got 10 minutes left to go in this half. Yeah. Griffith is her counterpart on Terminal City. She's also got four penalties as well.
Yep. All right, back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. That's number 15, Mac the Knife. And she is going to be opposed by number 101, Red Sonja for Terminal City. Red Sonja finding her way on the inside, picking up lead jammer status for Terminal City. Just like that. Followed closely by Mac the Knife. And it's a light pack there on the second straightaway. Red Sonja's the first one to get there. Scoots through on the outside. Gets blocked out to the outside. Not sure if she... Ah, she picked up a full 4 points there. That was great defense there from number 80 Thrill Show, putting her out to the outside. But apparently hips did pass hips. She was granted all the points she deserved. So, all right, back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. That's number 1223, Kim Janna. And she will be skating against... Where is that?
Sprout. Huh? That's number 10, Sprouting a Tail.
Sprouting a Tail. God,
this
I love that.
This next jam being brought to you by S1 Helmets. Be a lifer, get a lifer, S1 Helmets.
All right, Sprouting a Tail and Kim Janna trying to make their way through. Kim Janna finding a spot on the inside. She scoots through and picks up lead jammer status for Terminal City. Meanwhile, Sprouting a Tail looking to sprout through the pack here and pick up some points.
Kim Janna picking up 13 points so far on the day.
Number 11-11 Sundown getting blocked down to the track there. Kim Janna is through the pack. Calls the jam off. And grabs four more points for her team.
Yeah, she did that with absolutely wasting no time at all.
Yeah.
Very quickly. So you can tell Terminal City just, they're really wanting this right now. You can see that in the defense.
Terminal City there hitting the century mark at 100 points here. And Mad Rolandahl sitting at 38 points with just 8 minutes remaining in the first half here. Madison coach in there having some questions for Eric Rock.
Next jam being brought to you by Quick. Roll faster and farther with Quick ceramic bearings.
Quick indeed. Quick as Maiden Sane. Maiden Sane is through the pack, picking up lead jammer status for Terminal City. And she's already back at the back of the pack. Picking up some points for Terminal, looking over to her coach. Coach says, go ahead, call it off, and she does. Four more points for Terminal, and 0 points for Madison on that jam.
Yeah, Lady Hoo-Ha was on a charge there, but yeah, kind of knew what was coming on.
Yeah.
Knew that call was coming. I almost expected it a little bit earlier. As I said, you know, Terminal City is just seeming very, very focused on what they're doing right now.
Yeah, they are. I mean, it's not too late for Madison. Certainly, they have a whole half and some change here to play, so... if they can gather those pills together, I'm sure that they'll be able to stay competitive in this contest. Meanwhile, back at the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that's number 19, Anna Ward, jamming for Terminal City. And number 4, Mouse squeaking through on the outside, picking up lead jammer status for the team in white.
Now, that is what I'm used to seeing from Mouse, just finding those lanes and exploiting them.
Anna Ward getting recycled to the backs, coming in just as the Derby Supply penalty box gets rid of three blockers. And, well, here comes another one. We don't want that penalty box to be lonely. Meanwhile, Mouse calls the jam. Terminal City picking up 0 points on that jam, and we're waiting for points from Madison. Looks like there are no points for Madison there. Mouse choosing to call the jam off there. All right, so that's a 0-0 jam for both teams. Score still at 104-38. Back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that's D4 Magic Missile, and she'll be opposed by number 5-2, Aveda Perrone.
This next jam being brought to you by Powerdyne, performance place for the modern derby game, Powerdyne.
Magic Missile playing a little jammer-on-jammer defense, pushing Aveda Perrone to the outside. Aveda recycled to the back there. Three blockers in her way, but Aveda finds a line on the inside. She skirts through and picks up lead jammer status for Terminal City All-Stars.
Yeah, she did a beautiful job working to the outside.
Oh, no.
On the apex there.
It's happened again, Lou. That's D4, Magic Missile picking up a cutting the track penalty for Madison. Madison Jammer back in the penalty box. Aveda Perrone having a power jam here. Just two blockers for Madison on the track, and that is not going to do it. She scoots through, picking up five more points for Terminal City.
Yeah, Madison's really starting to find a lot of penalty trouble right now. Shenanigans has already picked up her fifth.
So both packs at full strength now. That's four blockers for Madison. Three of them up front, creating problems for Aveda Perrone. She is able to scoot past them and grab five more points for Terminal City.
And again, I love that constant motion by Aveda Perrone. If you're in front, she's going to go left or right and keep those legs moving. And
yep,
you're going to try to stonewall her, she'll push you through.
Aveda getting pushed out there by number 15, Mac the Knife, and deciding, I'll just call the jam off here. She's being assessed four more points by her jammer ref, and that brings the total on that jam to 19 points. And with just under 5 minutes remaining here, that brings our score to Terminal City 123, Mad Rolandals 38.
This next jam being brought to you by Bont. Lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots by Bont.
All right, jamming now for Madison. That's number 15, Mac the Knife, and she is going to be opposed by number 101, Red Sonja.
Mac gets that outside line shut down as Sonja finds a little room on the inside. Once again, Terminal City picking up that lead jammer status.
Yeah, Mac the Knife finding herself opposed by just three terminal blockers, but she is able to get through, completing her initial pass. Meanwhile, at the back of the pack, Red Sonja getting put out there by number 9mm Shenanigans. And just deciding, I'm going to go ahead and call this, just as Mac the Knife comes around. So 0-0 jam that time. 0-0 is kind of a palindrome, isn't it?
Yeah, it's close enough. And again, this another palindrome break brought to you by Radar Wheels. Gate man sees name, garage man sees name tag.
I like that one better than the cigar one. Anyway, here we
go. Tuna Nut is still my favorite.
Back on the Fast Girls Gates jammer line. That's number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha, being opposed by number 1223, Kinjana.
And we have full strength right now.
Whoa. Lots of bodies there pushing against each other. Kinjana trying to find her way through to the inside. Manages to trip over an opponent or a teammate. Goes down, but still manages to get up and pick up lead jammer status for the team in red, your Terminal City All-Stars. Meanwhile, Lady Hoo-Ha trying to work her way around the outside of the track there.
And she is driven. Eve Hollows is going to force her all the way back and getting a little help there from Flower Power.
Jenna at the front of the pack there, looking at a four brace of Madison blockers. Meanwhile, Lady Hoo-Ha able to scoot through. Oh no, scoot through to the penalty box, that is. That's the Derby Supply penalty box. And they have just absolutely been not the best friend for Madison in this game. Lady Hoo-Ha going to have to sit for 30 seconds here while Kinjana will just skate around unopposed. Both packs at full strength. And it looks like Madison's going to try to speed around the track here.
And we have seen seven scoreless jams so far for Madison. Oh, and we are going to get a track cut on Kinjana.
Yep.
So doing Madison a solid, giving them a power jam in return. I don't think she meant to really do that.
All right. Meanwhile, Lady Hoo-Ha is out of the Derby Supply penalty box, running up against that three brace at the front of the pack. Yep. That's number 90, Green Machine, trying to get in a last hit there. But she's unable to contain Lady Hoo-Ha, who's coming back around the track here. Both packs set up in the second straightaway. Lady Hoo-Ha looking to pick up some much-needed points for the Dairyland Dolls.
And Hoo-Ha is taking a little beating in that three wall there.
That's excellent defensive work there by number 69, Flower Plower. Number 31, Eve Hallows. Up.
And they're going to pick up a forearm. Another power jam.
Wow, and that jam ends with the Madison jammer in the box. Terminal picking up 3 points on that pass. That's 8 total points for Terminal in that jam to 3 points for Madison.
And we are at 131 to 41. 1 minute, 10 seconds left to go in this first half for number 5 seed.
Yeah, I'll bet Madison cannot wait to get off the track, get into the locker room, and start to try and dissect what the issue is with these jammer penalties. Meanwhile, back on the track, that's number 88, Maiden Sane, jamming for Terminal City. She is finding her way through there. That's number 565, Glock Ness, doing a good job of trying to keep her back. But you can only hold Maiden Sane back so long. She is out of the pack. Picked up lead jammer status for Terminal City.
Yeah, Palmer did a nice job opening up some room in the Mad Rollin' Dolls defense.
Yeah. Clearing lanes is Palmer's business, and business is good. Maiden Sane here looking to complete her first scoring pass.
And again, it's making that three wall very effective with that floating player. And a nice pop to the inside is going to send Lady Hoo-Ha into the recycle mode.
Yep. Whoa, what a move from Lady Hoo-Ha. Two blockers on her, trying to push her to the outside. He does a quick pirouette, stays in bounds. If only she could have picked up some points for that. That would have been awesome. Okay, well, it looks like we are in halftime here. Two more points picked up by Terminal City. That brings their total to 133 points, 41 for Mad Rollin' Dolls. And what do you think, Lou? I don't know. I think we were figuring this game would be a little bit more evenly matched, but it looks like Terminal City definitely came to play. They are coveting that number five spot. Yeah, we're looking at the whiteboard there, and you can see the numbers for the team in white.
Yeah, the big story, okay, let's get to our penalties. Terminal City with 22 penalties.
Right.
Madison with 24, but the big story on that, the jammer penalties. Terminal City picking up three jammer penalties, and Madison giving up eight.
Yeah.
And that four in a row on the first four jams just did not set a good tone for the start of this game on the Mad Rollin' Dolls. They seem to be kind of struggling, trying to regain their composure.
Yeah.
And it's one of those where Terminal City is doing a beautiful job. They've got a great defensive setup going. Madison's having a hard time doing it, and just some mental mistakes, it looks like to me,
definitely,
on the parts of the jammers. Just a tough day if you're wearing the star on the Mad Rollin' Dolls.
Yeah, both of these teams pretty well evenly matched. I mean, as we've seen in the earlier games in this tournament, but, you know, you give them that momentum, send the jammers to the box four times at the very beginning of the game and allow the opposing team to, you know, put up a couple of grand slams, and that's a hole you may not be able to dig yourself out of. So
And with Madison too, you've got Shenanigans with five penalties already, and that is their captain. And that could bring some trouble very early on into the second half if Terminal City tries to take advantage of that. Flower Power about the and Griffith, excuse me, the two players on Terminal City with four. So maybe have to look out a little bit right now, but I think Terminal City is feeling pretty good. They're in coasting mode. What they're doing is working. And if I was kind of feeling like them right now, or their coach was like, hey guys, you're doing fine.
Right.
Let's make Madison try to beat us. Let's not make any mistakes. Let's not adjust something to make it easy. What we're doing is working. Let's just stick with it.
Stick with it. All right. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go away for halftime, but don't forget to come back for the second half of this great game between Terminal City and Madison, here at the 2015 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs, live from Tucson. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Welcome back for the second half of this, the game, fifth place game for the 2015 International WFTDA Division I Tournament in Tucson, Arizona. So I'm Sexy Beast, and I'm here with...
I am Professor Lou Bottomy, and I'll tell you, Sexy Beast, it has been somewhat of an interesting game. Very early on, we saw Madison just getting into some penalty problems time after time after time again, and they've given up eight power jams so far this game. It's something they've had problems with this weekend, and definitely going to be something that they're going to need to work on the offseason this year.
Yeah, I'm sure that they spent a lot of time talking about that at halftime, and we'll see if they can get it together here and try to keep their jammers out of the box in this, the second half. Our score at the half is 133 for Terminal City in red, 41 for the Mad Rollin' Dolls in white. And with just under a minute here remaining before the start of the second half, you can see the whiteboards there on the track tell a little bit of the story penalty-wise for these two teams. Penalty trouble for many teams in the tournament this weekend. Some teams have been able to overcome it. Other teams have struggled with it. And we'll see how Madison can do here in the second half. Madison 1-1 so far in the international facet of this tournament. Beating Charm City, losing to Victoria, so beating Maryland, losing to Australia, and now they're trying to take out Canada. So we'll see how that works out for them. So,
well, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, you can talk directly to the WFTDA TV announcers live with the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA, and that is the number two. And kind of going big on Twitter, what's with all the forearms?
Yeah.
That has been a big story of the weekend. The other big thing on Twitter right now is the Maple Pants.
Yeah,
they
Maple
seem
Pants.
To be a huge crowd favorite.
Well, they seem to be very lucky for Terminal City. The Maple Leaf Pants are working out for them here in this game. And looks like we have got things figured out. We are ready to get underway on the Fast Girl Skates line, jamming for Terminal City. That's number 88, Maiden Sane. And she'll be opposed by number 4, Mouse, from the Dairyland Dolls.
So Mouse switching around inside to outside, back to the inside, trying to find a little line. Is Maiden Sane stuck behind a Madison four wall?
Mouse getting put to the outside herself there, having to recycle to the back of the pack. That allows Maiden Sane to come around the outside and pick up lead jammer status for the team in red, Terminal City All-Stars.
And as soon as they made Madison recycle, those blockers came back, opened up the lane for Maiden. So beautiful job by the Terminal City blocking crew.
Yeah, Mouse got her hands full here, or her paws full, I should say, at the front of the pack. That's a formidable two wall with number 16 Palmer and number 51M Simonius Simaximus, extending the boundaries of the pack all the way to the front.
And Mouse just trying to turn that shoulder, split him through. Does pop through.
Maiden Sane, having already been recycled numerous times, opting to call it off here, having picked up just 1 point. Correction, 2 points for Terminal on that jam. Maiden Sane picking up 2 points for Terminal. 0 points for Madison on that jam. First jam of the second half.
Hey, and no power jam.
Yeah.
That's a great start right now.
That's a plus for Madison so far. All right, back to the Fast Girl Skates start line. That's number D4. Magic Missile jamming for Madison, and she'll be opposed by number 19, Anna War, taking the star for Terminal City.
Anna's picked up 9 points in the first half.
Magic Missile getting a cycle to the inside there. Oh, blue. Magic Missile picking up a penalty. That is the first jammer penalty of the second half for Madison. And that is going to open up a power jam possibility for Anna War here.
I don't think I'm going to say anything else about power jams from Admiral and Dolls for the rest of the
just
game.
Just hum. You just be Meanwhile, that's number 69, Flower. Flower headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. That is her fifth penalty. And number 19, Anna War, making her way around, having completed her initial pass.
And getting a little help from Griffith up there.
Yep, it's a 3-on-3 pack at this point. Madison Jammer is out of the box, looking to complete her initial pass. Meanwhile, Anna War does pick up 5 more points for Terminal City.
Magic Missile tiptoes that inside line. I swear, every time I see that now, I get a little nervous.
Yep. Anna War giving a high sign to her blockers there. Does manage to make it through the pack. Looks like she picked up X number of points. Waiting on the jam ref here to toss up any points that she might have gotten. Anyway, I guess we're going to call that 0. So 5 points total on that jam for Terminal City. 0 on that second pass. So that brings our score to 140 for Terminal City and 41 for Mad Rollin' Dolls.
The Mad Rollin' Dolls doing their best to get back into this game. But Terminal City, like I said, they were playing consistent.
Well, I missed something there because Anna War is sitting in the Derby Supply penalty box. Not sure what the scenario was there, but that spells a power jam for Madison. And that's number 15, Mac the Knife, trying to make her way through the pack, getting crooked to the outside, managing to recycle there. Great defense at the front by number 1111 Sundown and number 16 Palmer.
Darling Nikki came up, tried to give her jammer a little bit of room there.
Looks like Sundown is headed to the penalty box, the Derby Supply penalty box, for an out-of-play penalty. And that is going to allow Mac the Knife to pick up lead jammer status for Madison.
So Anna War back on the track, trying to find her way through the Mad Rollin' Dolls defense. She gets driven to the inside, and I do believe that is Glock Ness making her recycle.
All right, Mac the Knife, having made her way through, has harvested 5 more points for Madison. That's 5 much-needed points for the Dairyland Dolls here in the second half. Just 2 blockers up front to beat, and she manages to do that. Picks up 4 more points for Madison.
So a 9-point start there. Anna War recycling her way back through again as we are going to have another penalty being called.
Yeah, that's 11-11 Sundown headed to the Derby Supply penalty box right now. And meanwhile, back in the second straightaway, both teams having set up there. Terminal City locked into that three brace, very successfully thwarting the Dairyland Dolls jammer.
Glockness comes up. Little bit of help there.
No.
We're going to see a forearm being called on Mac the Knife. I didn't say anything about it, I swear.
No, it wasn't you this time, Lou, trust me. But we have noticed a lot of forearm penalties being called on the jammers. Forearms and cuts are the problem there. And then we had, looks like we had a clockwise block being drawn on number 565, Glock Ness. She is headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. And Anna War, for all of her efforts, does not pick up any points on that jam. That was a tough one for her. 12 points total for Madison on that jam, bringing our score to 140-53, just under 25 minutes remaining in the game. And with the Madison jammer in the penalty box on the Fast Girl Skates line, jamming unopposed is number 52, Aveda Perrone.
This next jam is going to be brought to you by Sin City Skates. We wouldn't sell it if we wouldn't play in it. The first, the best, happy to fix the rest.
Aveda Perrone. Yes, no pass, no penalty being signaled by the jam ref. So Aveda Perrone, though she is on her first scoring pass, is not lead jammer. That will create an opportunity for Mac the Knife to come out and pick up lead jammer status for Madison.
And that was Aveda Perrone. Nice job by Aveda coming in on the inside, going to the outside, coming back through, and that little head fake just gets both of the Madison blockers just to bite just enough to give her that inside line.
All right. Looks like we have a official timeout here.
I've got a skater down on the inside. I'm not exactly who it is right now. She worked her way off the track before the end of that jam, though. Would like to go ahead and let you know about the recognized tournaments. The WFTDA Recognized Tournaments Program supports high-quality tournaments hosted by WFTDA members worldwide. Applications for the Recognized Tournament Program are open until September 30th. If your league is hosting a tournament this year, learn more about this program and apply at WFTDA.com/events. And also, marking its 10th year of pushing this sports athleticism and competition to new heights, the International WFTDA Playoffs and Championships bring together most talented skaters and teams in the WFTDA. Join us next week for the 2015 International WFTDA D1 Playoffs hosted by the Dallas Derby Devils. Live it or stream it live at WFTDA.com Dallas.
All right, that was number 131, Bruiseberry Pie. A little shaken up on the inside, but we are glad to see her get up and skate off the track. It is a contact sport, as we all know, so always grateful to see a skater get up and skate away after a hard hit like that. Back to the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. That's number 31, Lady Hoo Ha, jamming for the Dairyland Dolls, and she'll be opposed by number 101, Red Sonja, in red for the Terminal City All-Stars.
Lady Hoo Ha trying to find her way through that Terminal City wall, and they have just been doing a beautiful job setting up that back wall.
Yeah, Red Sonja seemingly more successful than most, making her way through there and picking up lead jammer status for Terminal City. He just loves to find an inside wall there. Yeah, manifests a little bit of a hop there, completes a little apex hop, and grabs four more points for Terminal City.
You know, one of the things I've been watching for this weekend, and we've seen it called a couple of times, when the jammers are finishing their jam, when they're going out of bounds, we've seen a call or two being done by they're going out a little bit too early.
Yeah.
So definitely been watching out on that a little bit. It's definitely something that you might be hitting your hips.
Yeah.
But unless that whistle is blowing, man, do not go out of bounds.
Don't do it. All right, jamming now for Madison. That's number 4, Mouse, and she'll be opposed by number 1223, Kim Janna. Kim Janna dancing around the front of the pack, makes her way through, picks up lead jammer status for Terminal City.
That was beautiful how she set that toe stop down and just did a pirouette off of it.
Mouse kind of shaking her head as she makes her way around. She, too, has completed her initial pass. Kim Janna comes through, earns herself 4 more points for Terminal City, and calls off the jam.
Terminal City feeling really comfortable right now.
Yes. I think that's just going to be their strategy, Lou. They're just going to you know, get through, get their points, call it off, get through, get their points, and just do what they can do.
Just the calm, cool.
Yep.
You know,
keep things going.
Yeah, Madison's got a lot of work to do to get into this game, and, you know, Terminal is happy to go ahead and let them do that work. Everything else seems to be working well for them.
Right. At 22 minutes left remaining with a 100-point lead, that's number 88, Maiden Sane, jamming for Terminal City, and she's opposed by number D4, Magic Missile.
They trade a little paint as they came off the Fast Girl start line.
There you go, Magic Missile through the pack first, picking up lead jammer status for the team in white. Maiden Sane having made her way through now, trying to come around for her first scoring pass. That's number 14, Darling Nikki, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box, followed by number B1T, Fang Dangled. I think that's Fang Dangled's first trip.
And Magic Missile is going to call that off as she sees the opposing jammer coming up. 2 points there for the Mad Rolling Dolls. So 153 Terminal City, 55 Mad Rolling Dolls. 21 minutes, 20 seconds left to go in this game.
All right, back on the Fast Girls Gate start line. That's number 19, Anna War, jamming for Terminal City, and she'll be opposed by number 15, Mac the Knife, wearing the star for Madison. Mac the Knife finding her way through the outside. She does pick up lead jammer status for Madison, followed very closely by Anna War.
And that is two in a row for the Mad Rolling Dolls.
Anna War putting the speed on there, trying to force Mac the Knife to call the jam. Madison at the front of the pack, speeding things up. Mac the Knife looking to get through, maybe pick up a point. Calls the jam off, having passed a couple skaters there. Yes, she does in fact pick up 2 points for Madison. Great and very smart jammer work there from Mac the Knife for Madison.
Yeah, she very smartly kept out there as long as she could, trying to get her blockers free.
Yeah.
From the Derby Supply penalty box.
You could see that she was ready there, holding her hands over her hips as she made her way into the pack. She's trying to get past a couple skaters there, picking up some much-needed offense for her team. Meanwhile, back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that's number 52, Aveda Perron. And she will be opposed by number 10, Sprouting a Tail.
And Aveda, again, finding that
wow.
line just so quickly. Sprouting a Tail, trying to find her way through. The Terminal City defense gets driven to the outside on turn number two. Tries to find a little seam to the inside now. Goes back to the outside.
Uh-oh, there's that forearm penalty again. Aveda Perron picking up a forearm for Terminal City. And that could spell a power jam for the Dairyland Dolls.
And the Dairyland Dolls really need to capitalize right now, if not just to get some momentum, to get a little bit of positive aspect going on into their game.
All right, that was number 1111 Sundown, and now number 16 Palmer, both headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. Palmer is being instructed to go around because the penalty box is full. Meanwhile, Sprouting a Tail, having completed her first scoring pass, has picked up 5 more points for Madison. This is an opportunity for Madison to generate some offense here. Just 2 blockers on the track for Terminal City to 4 for Madison. Number 5-2, Aveda Perron, is back out of the penalty box. Has come in behind the Madison pack and is looking to continue her scoring pass.
Sprouting a Tail does that little spin to the inside to get herself free of the pack.
Whoa.
Aveda Perron!
Man, oh! Yeah, that's definitely going to be a low block penalty for the Madison pivot there. Just at the front of the pack, Aveda Perron able to scoot through, though, and pick up 5 points for Terminal City. That's number 9mm Shenanigans getting that low block. Shenanigans now sitting at 6 penalties for Madison.
And I like how she had the who me look on her face as she's going over. I didn't hit her, really.
Aveda Perron not wasting any time, getting recycled to the back, but finding her way through on the inside. And she's going to grab 4 more points for Terminal City.
So smooth.
Oh, Sprouting a Tail, getting knocked to the ground there by a Terminal City blocker. That blocker is number 51M, Simonius Simaximus, getting sent to the Derby Supply penalty box for a Simaximus hit.
This next jam is going to be brought to you by Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates, 8 years dedicated to making a faster you. Check out the tournament sales at Fast Girl Skates this weekend only.
All right. Back to the Fast Girl Skates start line. That is number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha, jamming for Madison, opposed by number 101, Red Sonja, for the Terminal City All-Stars.
And Sonya quickly working to the front. Takes a little bit of the spill as she's popped to the inside. But Lady Hoo-Ha in on part of that. And
Lady Hoo-Ha picking up a back block there for Madison. Lady Hoo-Ha, maybe a little bit too much inertia there. And she found herself impacting the Terminal City Jammer in the back, putting her to the ground. Red Sonya having found her way into the back of the pack, looking to complete her initial pass here.
Shenanigans doing a job trying to hold back Red Sonya.
Bodies hitting the floor there between turns one and two.
Nice timed pop there by Brokeback Jack.
Yeah, managing to recycle Red Sonya to the back of the pack.
You know, both these teams kind of bringing back the big hits.
Yeah. There's plenty of them out there. Madison setting up a nice four brace at the front of the pack. Red Sonya trying to get that pass there. She does manage to get through on the outside. Uh-oh. My goodness. Red Sonya picking up a penalty there.
And we are going to have
an out of play penalty for Red Sonya there. It looks like a no pack was declared, and Red Sonya was still engaging up front there. So Terminal City picking up another jammer penalty here. Meanwhile, the Madison jammer, number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha, back on the track, fighting her way through there. Looks like it's a 4-2 pack advantage for Madison. Lady Hoo-Ha at the very front of the pack there, trying to find her way past those last two Terminal City blockers, and she does. Picks up 5 points for Madison there, bringing their score to 76. It's 165 for Terminal, 76 here for Madison. Lady Hoo-Ha coming back around for another scoring pass. Finds her way into the back of the pack, passes one skater, then two.
And we are almost 15 minutes into the second half. The Mad Rollin' Dolls already getting as many points as they did in the first half. They picked up 38 this second half so far. Actually, add a couple more there. That would be 41 points.
Bringing their total to 79 points here to Terminal City's 165. Madison picking up 3 points at the end of that last jam. And looks like we are in a team timeout for Terminal City. And I think that gives us a chance to thank or say something to somebody.
Well, let's before we thank everybody, let's take a look at our penalties right now. Amazingly even, Terminal City with 36 penalties, Madison with 35. The big disparage, 5 of those Terminal City penalties were power jams. Madison gave up 10.
Youch.
So that is kind of a big one. The story's on the board for Madison. We've got Shenanigans with 6 penalties, so she is in a bit of danger as the captain. Glockness has 4, Alligator has 4. For Terminal City, Flower Power picked up her 6th penalty. Palmer has a 4th, as well as Bruiseberry Pie. And it looks like Griffith, at the bottom, didn't see that. She has 6 as well. So. Yeah.
And Simonius and Maximus also sitting on 6 penalties right now. So those blockers for Terminal are going to have to watch their P's and Q's here if we want to have them be in the game for the remaining 15 minutes of this game. So,
well, that could really change things if Terminal City lost a couple of those blockers.
Without a doubt. And here we go. Jamming for Terminal City. That's number 1223, Kim Janna. She's through the pack. Out front, she is your lead jammer, followed very closely by number 4, Mouse, for Madison. Janna going to do her trademark scenario. She gets through, picks up her points, calls the jam off. Oh, looks like Mouse managed to get through and pick up one more point for Madison there.
I think the propulsion from her braids got her hips just past the other skin.
Braid power. There it is.
It works.
So 4 total for Terminal City on that jam, 1 for Madison. And we are ready to get things going here on the Fast Girl Skates line for the team in red. That is number 88, Maiden Sane, and she will be opposed by number 14. No, I'm sorry, that's number D4, Magic Missile, jamming for Madison.
This jam being brought to you by Jackson. Skate for the love of it, Jackson Skates.
Looks like a Madison blocker picking up a multiplayer block there. And that's going to allow Maiden Sane to get through and pick up lead jammer status for Terminal. And just like that, she is through the pack, picks up 5 more points for the Terminal City All-Stars.
A Magic Missile being caught with a cut track. So the troubles continue for the Mad Rollin' Dolls jammers.
Maiden Sane not worried about that. She's just got a few more blockers to get through. She does manage to do that, and she has earned herself 5 more points for the Terminal City All-Stars, bringing their total to 179 points to 80 points for the Mad Roland Dolls.
Lipsmacker now heading to the penalty bench. We have got a nearly full penalty bench, although a couple of them are getting sprung. Five in the penalty bench right now, and that is making it very easy for Maiden Sane to make these passes.
Yep, she's awarded five more points for that pass. Comes through three-on-three pack scenario here, happening between turns one and two. And just like that, Maiden Sane has earned herself four more points.
Missile breaks through the pack. She finishes her initial pass, and Maiden Sane keeping an eye on her. More than happy to kill a little time off there.
Yep. So Maiden Sane having picked up 4 points at the end of that jam for a total of 23 points. And for that reason, it should be no surprise that she is... I am surprised. She is not the high scorer right now for Terminal City. That is Evada Peron with 68 points. Maiden Sane sitting on 57. Kim Jenna with 33. Here we are, just over 12 minutes remaining. Terminal City 192 to Mad Roland Dolls 80 points. That's number 19 Anna Ward jamming for Terminal. And she's opposed by number 15 Mac the Knife for Madison. Both jammers still at the back of the pack there, dancing outside, inside. Whoa.
Mac the Knife getting popped there and picking up the cut.
Mac the Knife must have stepped inside, not realized that she had touchdown outside the track boundary. She has cut the track, and she's headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. Another jammer penalty for Madison. Another possible power jam for Terminal.
And that is the last we are going to see of Griffith. Griffith going to the penalty box. She picks up her seventh penalty. So Griffith will get the invite to watch the rest of the game.
Anna War, having made her way through, does pick up lead jammer status for the team in red. And now she's here on her first scoring pass. She does manage to come through. Pass a few blockers there, encountering some resistance at the very front of the pack. Gets knocked to the outside there.
Beautiful job there.
And chooses to call the jam off just as the Madison jammer is returning to the track.
So Thrill Show was giving some big pops there, pushing her to the outside.
Oh, is that who that was?
Yeah.
Yep. Number 80 Thrill Show for Madison. So 3 points for Anna War on that jam, bringing their total to 195. Wow. I guess that story really is, Lou, the jammer penalties for Madison. And you can see just by looking at the score there, that can easily account for that significant differential in offense for these two teams. Looks like we have an official timeout on the track right now.
Yes, I think they are dealing with Griffith right now. As we said, Griffith fouled out.
Ah.
And so they are going to send...
I think that's number 131, Brewsbury Pie. And she will sit for Griffith, or stand for Griffith, if you will. She appears to be standing now.
And Brewsbury's got to watch out herself. She's got six fouls as well.
Yep.
Flower power with six. So again, if Madison can somehow knock out those other two blockers, definitely changes Terminal City's defense. I don't know if it would change it enough to get Mouse and Mac the Knife and Lady Hoo-Ha that room they need to bring up, 105 points.
Yeah. But. And that whistle starts the jam. That's number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha jamming for Madison. And number 52, Evada Peron jamming for Terminal City. And she has found an outside lane, and she's taken it. Bursting through the pack, she's become your lead jammer for Terminal City All-Stars. Meanwhile, in turn two, both packs mixing it up there. Lady Hoo-Ha trying to find her way through that formidable Terminal defense.
Yeah, again, they've just been on fire. Their three walls have been beautifully set up using that floater.
Looks like Evada Peron has picked up a cutting the track penalty herself, and she's going to be followed by Lady Hoo-Ha. Well, this is a first, Lou. Both jammers in the penalty box at the same time. If they had three jammers, they'd probably all three have penalties, but...
A little merry-go-round action here. Gets them back out onto the track.
There you go, and Evada has found her way back onto the track. She's back in the pack. Oh, gets knocked to the outside. Momentum of the pack carried them forward, so she is able to hop right back in.
Yeah, very fortunate for the Mad Rolling Dolls on that last power jam that Lady Hoo-Ha was following Evada Peron in.
Yep, that's number 565 Glock Ness for Madison, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box, as well as number 9mm Shenanigans, and I believe that is her seventh penalty. Shenanigans completing the circuit here. Evada Peron has made her way back through the pack, picked up five more points for Terminal City. And unfortunately for Madison, another cutting the track penalty for number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha. She is headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. While she does that, Nevada Perone assessed 5 more points for Terminal City.
And Terminal City's whole group comes up beautifully.
Yep.
And Nevada Perone just follows Green Machine right through. And actually, this is Green Machine. She started last year. So effectively, just about her first full year of Derby, and she is playing in the divisionals at this level. I mean, pretty amazing.
That's quite a journey for her. All right, so with 8 minutes and 54 seconds remaining in this game, Terminal City having passed the double century mark at 218 points. Madison sitting at 80 points here, 218 to 80. Terminal City looking to cruise to the end of this game. Back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, that's number 101, Red Sonia. And with the Madison jammer in the penalty box, she will be starting this jam unopposed. Madison jammer now standing in the penalty box. Red Sonia finding her way at the front of the pack there. 3 blockers to beat, now 2, now 1. Madison jammer is back on the track, that's number 31, Lady Hoo-Ha. Red Sonia is out of the front of the pack. She's picked up lead jammer status for Terminal. Lady Hoo-Ha trying to fight her way past that Terminal 4 wall. Red Sonia finding her way back in there, trying to get something going on her scoring pass. Both packs at full strength now. Madison setting up in the back, developing a 4 blocker brace. Meanwhile, at the front, Lady Hoo-Ha with a 3 brace of her own to deal with. That's number 305, Wilson, doing a great job of anchoring that brace. Lady Hoo-Ha doing a little bit of jammer on jammer there with Red Sonia, but Red Sonia makes her way through, earns herself 5 more points for Terminal City.
Brokeback Jack gave her a nice little pop as she was getting through the pack there. Sonia's probably going to feel it, but I'll tell you what, man, the Mad Rolling Dolls, they are going to be having nightmares about Red Maple Leafs.
They're going to wake up in their nightmare and go to the penalty box and then realize it was all just a dream. All right, at the front of the pack now, right around the mid straightaway. Lady Hoo-Ha trying to force her way through that very effective defense from Terminal City. Palmer getting cycled to the inside, coming back to help out. Looks like that's number 8, B1T, Fang Dangled, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. Red Sonia getting dropped in, getting pushed to the outside. Uh-oh, looks like Red Sonia has, in fact, picked up a low block. Yep, it's a low block, and she is headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. And we are optimistic that this will give a chance to Madison to recover some of the offense that they have been surfeited here. At the very front of the pack, that's a 2 wall.
And we did see a pass there going.
Yep, looks like Darlene Nikki was handed the helmet cover there by Lady Hoo-Ha. Unable to get through there and pick up any points, though. 9 points for Terminal City on that jam, 0 points for Madison. We've got just over 6 minutes remaining here in this game. Terminal City sitting at 227 points to Madison's 80. It seems, Lou, like they've been sitting at 80 for a while there. Their offense appearing to have stalled here late in the second half.
Well, part of that story again, penalties, penalties, penalties. Yep. While both teams are fairly even, 44 to 45, Madison having one more penalty. The big story is the jammer penalties. Madison picking up, let's make that number 16.
Ouch.
And we've got 7 power jammer penalties given up by Terminal City.
Yeah, that was number 10, Sprouting a tail. Sprouting a cutting the track penalty. And she is in the Derby Supply penalty box. Meanwhile, that is Red Sonia having come out of the penalty box, starting the jam there, and able to pick up lead jammer status for Terminal City. Both packs at full strength. Red Sonia ready to start her scoring pass. Madison looking to set up some kind of a wall up front there. Uh-oh, and looks like Red Sonia's picked up a cutting the track penalty herself. Yeah, she was blocked to the inside by that Madison wall and did come in ahead of one of their skaters there. Yeah, a bit of confusion there. She wondered what was going on, and her team is telling her, get to the box. Let's get this over with. Meanwhile, Sprout Natale has come back on the track, completed her initial pass, trying to make her way through a 2 wall there at the front. And she does. And she picks up 5 points for Madison.
And I'll tell you, Sexy Beast, if you would have told me there was going to be nearly 30 jammer penalties in this game beforehand, I would have kind of just laughed at you.
Kind of inconceivable, but that is what we are looking at here, Lou. Sprouting a tail, finding a way back through the front of the pack. Exactly that, a nice little juke there. Number 80, Green Machine. Sorry, number 90, Green Machine. Sprouting a tail looking to get some more here. Meanwhile, Red Sonja out of the penalty box. Eve Howells following her in there.
Now, Flower Power and Bruiseberry Pie are both in the pack, and both of those skaters do have 6 penalties.
Yeah.
And it looks like they're going to survive that jam.
Well, Madison able to be very successful offensively in that jam. They did manage to pick up 15 points, bringing their total to 95 here. Hopeful in the last 4 minutes to break the century mark. 3 points for Terminal City there, bringing their total to 230. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. 230 for Terminal City, 95 for the Mad Rollin' Dolls.
Well, Mad Rollin', you know, you got to give them, they've got to get a little respect out of it. They picked up 38 points in this first half, doing much better in the second half, except for the penalties.
Yep. All right, jamming now for Madison. That's number 4, Mouse, and she's opposed by number 12, 23, Kim Janna for Terminal City.
And Janna's just been fun to watch today as a jammer. Just some really powerful moves, some nice hops, some good all-around play.
Yep, and that play continues. Looks like, sorry to say it, but it looks like Kim Janna has picked up a forearm penalty.
I really should stop talking about jammers.
Believe me, Lou, it's not you. Kim Janna in the Derby Supply penalty box, and that allows Mouse, number 4, Mouse for Madison to pick up lead jammer status for the team in white. She's completed her initial pass. She's looking to come around, try to find her way through that 3 wall at the front of the pack.
And again, that nicely braced 3 wall by Terminal City. The only way that you're going to get around, got to go to the outside, got to go to the inside.
Wow.
And as soon as you do, they are so good throwing that push.
Awesome defense there from number 305, Wilson. And number 16, Palmer.
Yeah, Palmer, I believe, was sent to the penalty for a forearm.
All right, meanwhile, Kim Janna has come back out of the penalty box. She's back in the pack, looking to continue her scoring here. Very effective 3 wall having been set up at the front by Madison. Meanwhile, Mouse scoots through on the outside. Picks up 5 more points for Madison.
And that is going to put him over the century mark.
All right.
So 62 points this second half for Madison.
Kim Janna with her hands full there at the front. That's number 14, Darling Nikki. And number 18, FT, Allie Gator, doing a great job of slowing down the scoring. But you can only slow it down for so long. That's number 305, Wilson, headed to the Derby Supply penalty box for Terminal. And the jam is over. Looks like Madison has picked up 7 points there.
The WFTDA would like to thank some of our great sponsors. Thank you to Derby Central, Something Inked, 5-on-5 Magazine, and Sin City Skate Techs for the Tucson Tournament, fixing all of our gear as it's needed.
All right, just a few more jams here on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. That's number D4, Magic Missile, jamming for Madison. And she is opposed by number 88, Maiden Sane, jamming for the Terminal City All-Stars. Aiden Sane getting cycled to the back by their number 565, Glock Ness. Oh, look at that. Maiden Sane finding her way to the front of the pack, picking up lead jammer status for Terminal City, followed closely by number D4, the jammer in white. That's Magic Missile for the Mad Rollin' Dolls.
That was, I almost want to say, that was a nearly violent pass as she came through. You saw arms flailing, and I was surprised there wasn't a big whistle there. But with that whistle being blown, we are going to get in one last jam for this game. So the WFTDA would again like to thank a few more of our sponsors. We'd like to thank Juice Wheels, Derby Inc., Sugar Skull Designs, Bay Area Derby Girls, and Rink Rash. For all you do, the WFTDA would like to thank you.
All right, looks like this will be the last jam, Lou, here on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. That's number 5-2, Aveda Peron in red for Terminal City. And number 15, Mac the Knife in white for the Mad Rollin' Dolls.
Oh, Mac the Knife just danced with the devil on that inside line.
Aveda Peron finding an inside lane and taking it, picking up lead jammer status for the Terminal City All-Stars. Coming around here on her first scoring pass. Madison setting up in back. Aveda finding her way through. And she manages to pluck 4 points from the ether. Correction, 5 points.
And
not wanting to end the game seemingly without one more jammer penalty. Mack the Knife headed to the Derby Supply penalty box with a forearm penalty.
We're going to finish it just like we started it.
Yeah. Consistency is important, but, you know, maybe, I don't know. Anyway, Aveda Perone picking up signals from her coach, coming around, earning herself 5 more points for Terminal City.
She realizes the game is in her hands right now. They've got the lead. They've got the points. Just wanted to finish this out a little bit more is Aveda Perone.
Looks like less than a minute left on the jam clock. Aveda Perone does make her way through the four-wall defense at the front of the Madison Pack, and she grabs 5 more points for the team in red.
And I love how she just ducked through that pack, but you also got to watch out on that or else you'll get the blocking with the head call.
Yep. That's the burden of the diminutive skater. You either get high blocked or you block somebody with the head. All right, Mack the Knife is back on the track. She's made her way through, completing her initial pass. Aveda Perone puts hands on hips, calls off the gem, having earned 5 last points in this game for Terminal City. And wow. Not ultimately the game that we expected, but one that definitely was able to, display the offensive and defensive talents of Terminal City, and also to sort of illustrate how one team can find themselves in significant penalty trouble. Unfortunately, that team was Madison. Our final score here, 252 for Terminal City, 102 for Madison.
Wow, and I'll tell you what, Aveda Perone, what a day for her. 111
nice.
Points.
Yep.
Unbelievable day. The second leading scorer on that, Maiden Sane with 59. And for Mad Roland Dolls, we're going to see Sprout and a Tail with 32 points. And the second leading scorer was Magic Missile after that. The penalties finished up. Terminal City picked up 52 penalties. Madison, 51. 25 jammer penalties in this game.
Yeah, that whiteboard in the middle of the track there looking like a completed crossword puzzle. So many things filled in there.
They had their work cut out for them.
Yeah.
8 jammer penalties for Terminal City, but the death knell for Madison on that, 17
yeah.
power jams given up. So,
well, congratulations to Terminal City. They finished 5th in the tournament, and also props to Madison. They finished 6th in the tournament here, both of them coming in lower seated and finishing higher seated, so they both have to be very happy with that. Yep. Terminal City finishing with a 3-1 record, Madison going 2-2, and you know, despite the penalty trouble that Madison suffered, I still think this was definitely a worthwhile contest. Both of these two teams got to feel pretty good about having come to Tucson. So,
well, it's one of those things. I think Madison can come out of this and go, okay, let's look over these tapes. Let's look at what we're doing. What do we need to clean this up? What is the problem with the penalties? And they've been one of these teams that have been around since
yes.
almost day one.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of knowledge. There's a lot of strength in their ability.
Yeah.
And so Madison, I really would like to see them come back next year cleaning up some of these problems.
Yep, I'm sure they will. It's a lot of times, you know, when you have the sort of crucible of focus that you get in this level of tournament, you know, teams find things out about themselves, things that they need to improve, things that they can't improve. And, you know, so it's good. It's good either way. So anyway, Lou, thanks so much. It was a great call. Looks like we are just about to throw it down to our cameraman here. So take it away.
Lock in. We have a tendency to have skaters kind of roll backwards as the interview goes on. Thank you very much, Lou Bottomy and Sexy Beast. I'm here trackside now post-game with Eve Hollows and Palmer, a couple of the victors from Terminal City All-Stars, who've now finished 5th here in the Tucson Division I tournament. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
As you're catching your breath, we're going to start, let's start big picture here. It's been a really fascinating year, I think, for Terminal City All-Stars. You guys went 8-6 in sanctioned play, had some highs, had some lows, but you played kind of the best. What do you think this year has meant for Terminal City in terms of your growth and development as a league and as a D1 All-Star team?
We've had a big changeover in our team. We've lost some due to retirement and injury, and we picked up a lot of transfers.
Yeah.
We have a rookie, Green Machine.
Yeah, she's
been skating 10 months.
She's been skating 10 months.
So it's kind of been rebuilding, but strong rebuilding for us, I think.
We feel stronger than ever, for sure.
Yeah, you picked up Maiden Saint at the end of last year. Brewsbury Pie, another one who's come in during the regular season, so you guys have really bolstered your numbers.
Yes.
Now, it has been a new year for you guys, but you guys had some historic victories this season. Of course, finally beating Rat City, finally beating Montreal. What did those victories do for the morale of the team going forward?
Oh, there's no words. I mean, we did not expect to beat Rat at all. We went in that just like hearts full and gave it our all, and we were really, really happy with the results, obviously. Montreal.
So it set up, what it did set up is that you guys ended up 27th in the WFTDA. You came in here as the seventh seed, knowing that you're going to have a tough road through Bay Area. Dominated the opening game, had a hard time against Bay Area, but the Bay Area, though, you did actually improve on the score you had against them in the matchup earlier in the year. What do you think was different about the games? Confidence? Was it the training? What changed?
I think we've played Bay a couple times now, and we just keep improving every time we play them. They're one of our favorite teams to play. They're so physical and so amazing that, you know, you can't help but learn from them, right?
Yeah. Last year, you were also in this consolation game, the fifth place game. Different result, though. You fell in that one. How does it feel finally to get back into that fifth spot? You're basically the consolation bracket champions, right? You win fifth place.
Yeah.
It feels so good. It feels so good to win our last game and last game of the season. Like, we've worked so hard. Our team has learned each other and how to work together, and to get here feels so good. Yeah.
Well, congratulations, guys. Soft-spoken blockers off the track, devastating jammer killers on the track. Stay tuned, of course. Coming up, the all-important third-place game. Who will book their ticket to St. Paul in the WFTDA Championships? Rocky Mountain versus... Rocky Mountain versus arch-rival. Coming up on WFTDA.TV.